Yesterday we have discussed about this mechanism. Whatever the protein are there, a translated protein, so this protein exactly, there are two types of protein, completed protein and partially synthesized protein, okay. So we have discussed yesterday about completed protein, they undergo post-translational import, that is very important. Post-translational import. Okay, what is the post-translational import? Means post-translational modification, okay. And glycosylation, O-glycosylation. Glycosylation, this is the, and then glycolipid, okay, addition, and then GPI anchor addition, okay, GPI anchor addition. Let me check. I think there is some problem. Okay. So, yes. So, this is the post-translational modification. So, what is the complete history? Complete history is like that. Let me start the blackboard. Okay. So, I think more faster way of getting the concept, right? So what I'm taking, this is a complete cell, suppose, all right? What happened? This no smooth drawing. Yes. So now you can see the, we have discussed that this is a nucleus, okay? And yesterday we have discussed about ki what is the role of NES, hana? So mRNA after the synthesis, they are coming into the cytoplasm, there is a ribosome, right? So there are two type of proteins, one is completed and other is co-translational protein, okay. So first you should remember it well, okay. What you should remember well about the classification, co-translational, right? So completed protein, they must undergo the post-translational modification, PTM. I have discussed post-translational modification, why this is essential, because this is a stable protein, right? N-glycosylation, O-glycosylation, right? What is others? Lipid anchor, okay? Addition of lipids, and then GPI anchor. Any sort of mismanagement or lacking post-translational modification, this become problematic, okay? Why they become problematic? Because folding will be issue. Folding will be issue. And you know, there is a Golgi stacking. What is the organelle? Called as the Golgi. Okay. So, protein synthesized, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Immediately they are undergoing the ER. ER ko kal humne kya padha tha? This is an ER, and then protein is moving to Golgi bodies. So Golgi body is the main place of post-translational modification. Earlier we have seen about the SRP receptor. SRP receptor. So they are available at which place? endoplasmic reticulum membrane. Here is the SRP receptor to receive the protein. Whatever the protein are floating in the cytoplasm, especially membrane protein, so they must be captured by the SRP-SRP interaction. SRP receptor, I have told you, there are SEC-61 protein is there, right? So, SEC-61 and 63, yehi tha na?
Yes, sir. 62 and 63.
Ha. 62 and 63. Okay. So, you will see the SRP, this consists of SEC-63 lying inward and outward both, okay. But SEC-62 remain outside. So, whatever the protein is there, they have the signal sequences, lies at the end terminal, right. And whatever the SRP protein is there, SRP protein, they are binding to these signal sequences midway, right? Yahan pe bind karna hai inko. And then they are interacting with this SRP receptor, and then translocation start with the translocon. Okay, translocon. So I've told you there is an internal enzyme which cleaves the signals. And what is the name of enzyme? Signal peptidase. Okay, signal peptidase is there, which is removing the signal, and in the unfolded form, this is a unfolded form. They are coming inside the ER, okay? They are coming inside the ER, and in the ER, there is a BIP, another HSP 70 protein, and outside there is a also HSP 70 protein, Hertzog protein. Okay, so the primary objective of this HSP 70 or this BIP protein is to prevent them from improper folding. Otherwise, what will happen if there is improper folding? Improper folding is there. They must be degraded by mechanism of ERADE. Okay, ERADE. And you know, ERADE is the best mechanism of degrading the all the improper folded protein by ubiquitin ligase. Ubiquitin ligase is there, which carrying all these improper folded protein into the cytosol, okay, and then in the cytosol there is a addition of ubiquitin, and then there is a proteasomal degradation. So what is happening if a large amount of unfolded protein accumulates, then the response is activated in the ER cytosol, which is called as the unfolded protein response, UPR. Then this is called as the unfolded protein response, called as the UPR, unfolded protein response. So this is a special protein which is exactly binding this unfolded protein, and then they are bounded by the ubiquitin ligase, and then they are coming in the cytosol, where all the protein is marked by a specific protein called the ubiquitin, and then proteasomal degradation is started, because the proteasome complex, they are going to identify those protein which are marked with the ubiquitin. Okay, clear? This is clear?
Yes, sir.
So, the ERADE mechanism is important. Many times it has been asked in the examination. Right? So, इम्प्रॉपर फोल्डिंग एंड यू कैन आस्क मी ए क्वेश्चन कि हाउ द सेल इज गोइंग टू डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन द प्रॉपरली फोल्डेड प्रोटीन एंड इम्प्रॉपरली फोल्डेड प्रोटीन. सो देयर इज अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोफोबिक प्रोटीन एक्सपोज्ड. जनरली इन द फोल्ड प्रॉपरली फोल्डेड प्रोटीन देयर इज ए ओनली वन और टू हाइड्रोफोबिक सिक्वेंसेज एक्सपोज्ड, बट हियर देयर इज ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ what present hydrophobic proteins are there exposed. This is a identification mechanism for UPR activation. Okay, that is called the unfolded protein response. There must not be high accumulation of the protein, unfolded protein. Immediately this will be degraded by the irate, because this is occurring in the inside the cytoplasm of endoplasmic reticulum by the proteasomal pathway. That's why this is called as the irate. We will discuss a little bit more about this mechanism, but this is a very fruitful mechanism. This is a very useful mechanism. So you can ask me a question ki how this all was discovered, hai na? Because post transplant modification, you will see there is a certain order is followed, specific order is followed. What is the order that is followed? The order that is followed is, first there will be N-glycosylation, addition of sugars, okay, and then O-glycosylation, then lipid addition, and then addition of GPI anchor. So CSIR has asked role of GPI anchor, ki agar ye GPI anchor remove kar dein, then what will happen? If N-glycosylation ko remove kar dein, then what will happen? Also there is a question, what is the need of post-translational modification, PTM? So if you are talking about the role of post-translational modification, exactly they solve two purpose, right? So PTM there is addition of some additional component, okay? And that additional component is very, very fruitful in the term of transport, because via the Golgi, they have to be transported. Okay, so some modification is occurring in the ER and some modification occurring in the Golgi. Okay, so there are two type of modification. So you can ask me, what is the mechanism of transport from ER to Golgi body? So if there are dangerous things are involved, for example, lysosomal protein. Okay, then what will happen? If lysosomal protein is there, what will happen? They must be transported by the inside the vesicle, because they may be dangerous to the cell. So that's, you can see there is a forward and retrograde transport, okay, and there is a retrieval signal also. So we have discussed yesterday that Golgi to ER, hai na, Golgi to ER, there is a one transport GER, and retrieval signal is attached, and the protein is destined from ER to Golgi body. So this things have been asked many times. So post transplant modification, everything, because N-terminal is modified by the addition of sugar. So mostly you will see there will be 14 sugars which are attached, and then in a stepwise manner 3 glucose molecule are removed. Okay, so this is the N-glycosylation, which occurs as a specific amino acid, because the protein is going to be modified. So a specific amino acid is involved, and that amino acid is especially asparagine. Okay, so asparagine modified, then there is a N-glycosylation, and if there is a another amino acid is involved, which is a different, and this is a C-terminal, then this is called the O-glycosylation. So this is saving the protein from degradation, because if they are not post-translationally modified, so there was a reconstitution experiment that was performed. Reconstitution experiment. What we will say? Reconstitutional experiment that was performed right. What is the name of experiment? Reconstitution experiment. So reconstitution experiment, what's all about? Means if you are creating a mutant, that lacks enzyme that adds N-glycosylation, that modifying the protein by addition of the sugar at N end, that is called the N-glycosylation. Okay? So if you are creating the mutant, they are not able to export properly. This was observed. Okay, similarly with the O-glycosylation, right? And GPI anchor has a very specific role. Not all protein is modified with the GPI anchor, but certainly there is a order is followed in the post-translational modification, that is N-glycosylation, O-glycosylation, then lipid addition, then GPI anchor in the last. We will discuss about that. So creating, this was called as the reconstitution experiment. Why? Because if you are creating the mutant and then replacing, mixing with the normal one. So mutant, and then it was not able to export, and then you mixed with the normal cell, then it was able to export. So it was identified that the post-translational modification is certain. It's a very important mechanism. It must occur properly, and there is a series of mechanism involved. Lots of mechanism is involved. Okay, so we have discussed a lot. Let us study in the detail. So I hope this kind of study on the blackboard is very helpful in understanding the complex examples and diagrams and the explanations. So that's why I started this first page that is related to the blackboard. What is your feedback? What do you want to say? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So what do you think? This is helpful in understanding,
yes, sir,
the complex things in proper way. Okay. So it will also help you in recreate all the images. If you want to recreate on a white blank paper, then you can draw in that way, and then you can start the story, and then you can recall all that things. Right, Lakshmi?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us start with advanced study. So study we have discussed also about the this one, that is signal sequences, membrane of the ear. Now you are able to understand it in more depth, what I'm talking about, the signal peptide sequence, membrane of ear, amino terminal KDL sequence. And it was, this question was also asked, if you are removing KDEL sequence, then what happens? So whatever the protein is destined to, what is the function of KDL? Targeting lysosomal protein to lysosome. In lack of KDEL, they will not be able to, वैसे तो -6-phosphate होता है lysosome के लिए, but KDEL is basically not for lysosome. Very sorry. Removal of KDEL sequence results in whatever the protein that should be targeted toward the luminal surface of ear, they are not moving to the luminal surface of ear, rather than get stuck somewhere at the plasma membrane. Okay, so this question can be designed such question, ki if you are removing KDEL sequence, what will happen? What will be the consequences, right? If you are removing the NLS, then what will happen? Then it's a better way to test the creating the mutant. Okay, so they can give you the story, ki suppose there is a cells which are lacking in the NLS sequences, right? And then what may be the following consequences, which one is true, which one is wrong. PTS for the peroxisome, right? Minus 6 phosphate. So if your cell is lacking minus 6 phosphate, the lysosomal protein will not be able to target here in the lysosome. So remembering this will help you a lot. And again, if you'll see, what about the co-translational mechanism, which is partially synthesized protein? So here, after the post-translational import goes to cytosol nucleus, mitochondria, plastid, peroxisome. This is very important to you. And if they are co-translational protein, then they are modified in the ER, and then they goes to Golgi apparatus. Okay, and the Golgi apparatus, there is one more modification is there. So there are two steps of modification. One in the ER, and other in the Golgi apparatus. So now the question is there. Okay, what kind of things would be carried out by the secretory vesicle, right? So mostly you can see, if the protein is going into the lysosomal, especially, they must be carried out by the secretory vesicle. And secretory vesicle, I have discussed that yesterday, they can be transported by the following mechanism: COP2, then COP1, right? COP2 is anterograde, COP1 is retrograde, and this was asked in the CCR. Retrograde, this is COP2 mediated is anterograde. If there is any feedback and any suggestions, you can give me, because you are the future scientist, and everything is for you only. So you should feel comfortable. एंटीरोग्रेड, जो भी स्टाइल हमारी पढ़ाने की बहुत ज़्यादा पसंद आती है वो चीज़ हमें बता दिया करो, बिकॉज फ्रूट सेलर डोंट नो विच वन इज बेटर फ्रूट्स. ओके, वो सारा मिक्स करके फिर खिलाएगा आपको अगर आप फीडबैक नहीं दोगे तो इन वेरी सिमिलर फैशन, वट एवर द स्टाइल यू फाइंड मोर ग्रेस्पेबल एंड ईजी टू रिमेंबर फॉर यू, यू शुड लीव ए स्मॉल फीडबैक आफ्टर एंड ऑफ द क्लास आर इन बिटवीन द चैट. If you cannot say anything, because always there is a scope of improvement. So COP2 is anterograde and COP1 is retrograde. Okay, and secretory vesicle, and then another is cladrin coated. So where cladrin coated concept is there, this is applies especially in the, kahan pe apply hota hai cladrin coated vesicles? RME receptor mediated endocytosis. तो स्पेशली अगर देखो तो सेक्रेटरी वेस्किल का पर्पज ही क्या है, एंडोसाइटोसिस. ओके, तो वहाँ पर क्लासिफिकेशन में हमने दिखाई थी, देर आर थ्री मैकेनिज्म ऑफ वेसिकुलर ट्रांसपोर्ट बेसिकली. वॉट इज द थ्री मैकेनिज्म, टेल मी. वन इज द एंडोसाइटोसिस, एंडो, एक्सो, एंड थर्ड वन इज ट्रांसाइटोसिस. सो मैनी ऑफ द वायरसेस एंड दिस लाइसोसोमल प्रोटीन इवन दे आर यूटिलाइजिंग दिस मैकेनिज्म ऑफ रिसेप्टर मेडिएटेड तुम लोगों ने फीडबैक भरा था जो हमने लिंक दिया था उस पर ऐप पे
भर
दिया था. ओके, मैंने चेक नहीं किया. चलो, तो ये क्लियर हो रहा है ना, बिल्कुल आपके सामने सीन चल रही है पूरी स्टोरी. दिस क्लासिफिकेशन अगेन आई एम डिस्कसिंग, बिकॉज दिस क्लासिफिकेशन यू मस्ट रिमेंबर, एंड वन क्लासिफिकेशन विल गेट यू द एग्जैक्ट आइडिया, एंड यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू कन्फ्यूज इफ एनी क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड, है ना. ओके, तो वैसे कि सेक्रेटरी वेसिकल का कॉन्सेप्ट क्या है, if there the protein is transported by endocytosis, endocytosis may be of two type, simple endocytosis or RME, receptor mediated endocytosis. ठीक है, एक्सोसाइटोसिस अंदर से बाहर जाना. ओके एंड ट्रांससाइटोसिस, कैन यू गिव द एन एग्जांपल ऑफ ट्रांससाइटोसिस? एग्जांपल से सर में पूछा हुआ था, व्हाट इज द बेस्ट एग्जांपल ऑफ ट्रांससाइटोसिस, क्योंकि बहुत सारे बच्चों को पता होता है एंडोसाइटोसिस एक्सोसाइटोसिस एंड यू नो आर यम्मी एंड एंडोसाइटोसिस रिसेप्टर मेडिटेड एंडोसाइटोसिस. ज़्यादातर वायरसेस आपकी बॉडी में जाने के लिए इसी का सहारा लेते हैं, क्योंकि ये रास्ता है जिससे लाइसोसोम पैक होता है. और खास करके ट्रिपैनोसोमा एक है, वो कैंसर वाले जो वायरस हैं, वो आपका कोरोना वायरस भी इसी के थ्रू इंटर किया बॉडी में, राइट? तो रिसेप्टर मेडिटेड एंडोसाइटोसिस. और ट्रांससाइटोसिस का क्या एग्जांपल है, एनी आइडिया? नो आइडिया? वन आइडिया कैन चेंज योर लाइफ. जस्ट गेस करो, जस्ट मेक ए गेस. नो गेस? आवाज कट तो नहीं रही आज? आवाज में ब्रेकेज तो नहीं है? मैं रिकॉर्डिंग हो रही कि नहीं यार? यस बोलो बेटे. Any guess for transcytosis? Mother's milk, okay? जो बच्चे को दूध पिलाती है मदर्स, ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग. दिस द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ट्रांससाइटोसिस. बच्चा तभी दूध पीता है when in the smaller vesicle a lot of milks are packed and they are coming to the breast यहाँ पे आते हैं glands पे. Okay, and then when the baby is suckling, and then these small vesicle is going to be, you know, release the milk. So this mechanism was called as transcytosis. This is clear? Yeah. Milk gland active होती है. इसका बहुत बड़ा mechanism, बहुत अच्छा है. Transcytosis को कहते हैं. Okay. तो आज तो मेरा टारगेट ये था कि मैं ये पढ़ाऊंगा, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली ये नहीं पढ़ा रहा आज, बिकॉज इसके पहले बहुत सारी. हाँ, गेट गेट का कॉन्सेप्ट बड़ा अच्छा लगा मुझे, है ना? गेट वन गेट टू. हम लोग ज़्यादातर क्या जानते हैं, बाय वन गेट वन, राइट? है ना, बाय वन गेट वन. तो सेल में भी हमारे होती है गेट वन गेट टू. अगर आप एक काम करोगे तो आपको दो काम मिलेगा, राइट? एंड दिस इज ए रिसेप्टर. दिस गेट वन गेट टू इज ए कॉम्प्लेक्स रिसेप्टर विच रिक्वायर ए स्पेशल कोफैक्टर TRC40. दिस इज वेरी सिमिलर टू SRP एंड SRP रिसेप्टर.